morning, Cyber friends. Midi Man coming back at you again from Walker's Music with yet another word for the day. It's Friday, people. Yeah, I know. We always said, thank God it's Friday. At any rate, we made it to the weekend, and we give God the praise and all the glory and the honor. Giving a shout out to the YouTube fam from Baby Justice all the way up to Big Papa JT, as well as Mama JT. Y'all already know what time it is. Also to the End Time Harvest Gang, Brother L.A. from Kingdom Knowledge, Elder Michael McCray, Elect Sister 777, Sister Kate, also Sister Linda and Brother Leonard. We give all of y'all your accolade this morning. Papa J.T., Brother J.T., Little Brother Orange Flavor, Lady D, all that makes up their whole family circle. And we kind of blessed and a privilege to have y'all acquaintance, even if it's just in cyberspace, has nothing to do with anything. I feel sometimes people that my net family is more closer to me than close-knit family as far as the physical people that I deal with and touch with on a daily basis. I don't consider any of you any less than I do the one that I physically see every day sometimes. So in other words, just friends and family. That's what it's all about. Matter of fact, our common bond is to Christianity. In other words, our relationship with Jesus Christ makes us all one. And that's a good thing. That's a good thing. I just want to say, I often talk about TV evangelists and what we call TV evangelists. I mean, you know, that's just a stigma that people put placed on a label on the pastors and teachers and preachers of the gospel that just happen to be on TV. They call them TV evangelists. But nevertheless, whatever medium that we use to get the gospel out, it doesn't matter, long as the gospel get out. But one of my favorite, I mean, I feel that she is no doubt my favorite. And I don't say this here just to try to get brownie point, because I never met her in person. I never met her in person, but I've only seen her over the television airwaves. But my favorite teacher, preacher, evangelist of all time is no one other than Joyce Meyer. Crazy about Joyce Meyer. I love her teaching. And call it practical, down to earth. She don't try to get all up there with this fancy big words and all this stuff. She just put that stuff down plain and easy where everybody can understand it. And I love it. I love her teaching. And matter of fact, I try not to miss her not one day. I try to catch some of her episodes that comes on from the various networks, even if it's not on TBN or even INSP. And I think she even come on some of the other various networks, like Church Channel and whatnot. But at any rate, I said that because something Joyce spoke of the other day, and I felt that it was so powerful. And I thought about my own self, and I mean, in my life, and the thing that I had to do and overcome. Some things I'm yet trying to overcome, but nevertheless, I've thought about something when she said, when we pray. You know, Jesus said in these last days, people, and that's what we're talking about now, these last days, that many would be offended. It seems as though now that it's so easy to offend people. They are very easy to get offended. That's a dead sign that we are in the end time, because Jesus said, made this statement. Joyce said that when we pray, in other words, she gave an example of what Jesus meant. If you have any ought against anyone, when you pray and when you stand before the altar trying to offer up your gift, you leave your gift at the altar and go and be reconciled to your brother and ask forgiveness from him, and then you come back. And the Jewish people have been doing this for years, but somewhere along the way, we Christians, we've forgotten about that idea. And Joyce made it very plain the other day when she said, when we pray, she used to pray like this, you know, she's like, well, after we acknowledge God as our Father, we should say like this, it's like, our Father who art in heaven, I'm not mad at anybody. And if I have anything in unforgiveness in me, please, Lord, take it out right now. In other words, that should be the way we should line it up. Our Father who art in heaven, I am not mad at anybody. And if I got any unforgiveness in my heart, show it to me. And God will show it to you, and then you can get it right, and then you can live a successful life. That is so powerful, people. And that is the key today to what I want to talk on in just a couple of minutes here. When we have this unforgiveness in our lives and in our heart, we hurt no one but ourselves. Now, can people do you wrong? Of course they can. They do you wrong every day. And I'm like this here. When anytime you feel that somebody have done you so wrong that you can't forgive them, look at the nail prints in Jesus' wrist, and look at the nail print in his feet, and look at the wound in his side. Anytime that you feel that somebody done you so wrong, think about Christ and what they done to him. And then I don't think you would have any room to complain, to think that you can hold unforgiveness toward anyone. Jesus was out there hanging on that cross. Done been beat, almost beat to death before he was even put on the cross. And then he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. But nevertheless, we can't stand for somebody to kind of call us out of our name. No, that's not going to work. And as George Myers' show says, enjoying everyday life. If we're going to ever enjoy our lives, people, we're going to have to learn to forgive. Because let me tell you something. If you look at your Lord's Prayer, if you look at the prayer, it said, Lord, forgive me as I forgive others. In other words, ain't no sense in me and you going to God talking about forgive us, and we ain't forgive and gave our brother that we see and sister that we walk with every day. We want people to do unto us, but we don't want to do unto them. That's not going to work. In other words, you must forgive. How many times? 70 times 70. That's 490 times a day. And I don't believe no one around can offend you that many times a day. I just don't believe it. What that saying is, Jesus was saying every time want to offend you, and if they come back and repent, you forgive them. Now, I'm going to add one little thing to that, and I hope you heard that. Jesus said, if they repent, then you forgive them. And then I heard someone say, well, okay then. Well, if they don't repent, I don't have to forgive. Well, that part is on them. I want God to forgive me of my trespasses, so therefore, I'm going to forgive you every time you trespass against me. Because I'm looking at my own self, because I know that I want my Heavenly Father to forgive me of what I do. And according to that prayer, as I forgive, he will forgive me. And people, we can't go around with animosity and being offended all the time. You're hurting no one but yourself. You're just giving your own self high blood pressure and send yourself up for a stroke without holding all this unforgiveness in your heart against people. And a lot of times the people that you are mad at and so jealous of and whatnot, them people not even worried about you. You up here half sick to death because you can't stand to see somebody. And they're there going on enjoying themselves. They ain't studying about you. You are the one hurting. So I'm just saying, I'm challenging everyone on this Friday. Let's learn to forgive. And when we pray, starting the day, let's just say, Lord, I am not mad at anybody. And if I got anything in my heart against anyone as for unforgiveness, show it to me. Show it to me. And then get rid of that mess. Get rid of that junk and enjoy your life. This is Mini Man saying, whatever you get into, if God is not in it, get out of it. This is Mini Man saying, have a great weekend. And remember what I said, if you're going to drink, don't drive. If you're going to drive, don't drink. Because the life you save may be your own. This is Mini Man saying, peace. Goodbye.